Keyvokers!
What up, guys? This is
Keyvokers!
Back here again with another video. Today we're going to be doing an achievement breakdown on Disney classic games Aladdin and Lion King. This game offers 1,000 achievement points or 1 platinum trophy, and the estimated time for completion is 1 to 2 hours. I gotta say, they definitely didn't distribute these achievements evenly. Aladdin has 850 points, whereas Lion King only has 150 points. So basically, we're mostly going to be focusing on Aladdin here. These games were brought back by the same developer that did the SNK collection, which is popular for having really easy achievements because of the watch mode. This quote-unquote lets you watch the game, however we can jump in at any time, and we are definitely going to use this to our advantage. On top of that, some of the old Sega Genesis cheats work, and it's going to help us get the last couple achievements. So we're going to start off with the achievement that I got first, which is the short and sweet achievement for beating the Aladdin trade show demo. You can get this achievement in watch mode. You just need to fast forward until the end of the demo and then jump in. And once you finish the demo, your achievement should pop. Next, we have the monkeying around achievement. This achievement would be really hard. I think these Abu bonus rounds would have been the hardest achievements if we didn't have ways to get around it. These next few achievements are miscellaneous achievements that you're going to be getting in Aladdin. I posted an Aladdin achievement guide to help you get all of the achievements, so make sure you check that out. You can get all of these achievements in watch mode, and in my video I explain the exact point where you should fast forward to and stop and jump in. That way it's nice and easy, and you can just jump in at each achievement point and unlock all of your achievements nice and easy. For instance, if you're playing watch mode inside of the Final Cut version of Aladdin, the Abu bonus round is going to be at 6 minutes and 4 seconds. Well, that's the end of the round, right before the achievement pops. This next achievement is the only secret achievement in the game. It's for finding the peddler on the Agrabah rooftops. You can do this by throwing an apple at the smoking pot. I also have a timestamp for this one available, so you can get it nice and easy. This reveals a secret area where you can find the peddler. Next, we have an achievement for defeating Rasul. This is the first boss in the game. All of the boss battle achievements can be awarded in watch mode as well. I'm going to have timestamps for those in my Aladdin video. Next, we have an achievement for defeating our second boss, which is the Shiva monkey. That's in the Cave of Wonders level. That achievement is worth 50 points. Again, we can get this in watch mode. This next achievement is for Abu's second bonus round. These achievements are worth 150 points a pop, so you can only imagine how hard this would be if we didn't have the watch mode or the rewind feature or the save feature. I mean, kids have it good these days. Back in the day, we weren't even able to save our game. Next, we have an achievement for defeating Iago, which is Jafar's parrot. That is the third boss in the game. We can also get this in watch mode. Just check out the timestamp that I have available in the Aladdin video. And then finally, we have an achievement for defeating Jafar at the end of the game. This can also be awarded in watch mode. And then right after you defeat Jafar, you are going to get an achievement, A Whole New World, which is for beating the Final Cut version of Aladdin. So at this point, we only have 6 achievements left, 3 for Aladdin and 3 for Lion King. These achievements are actually the same, just different games, therefore beating the games on easy, beating the games on normal, and beating the games on hard. We need to make sure to select the S version of the game, which is the Sega Genesis version. Now, watch mode will work for normal difficulty, however, it will not work for the easy and hard difficulties. The reason is because by default, watch mode plays in normal difficulty. So you can use the watch method for beating Lion King on normal and beating Aladdin on normal. This will leave us with 4 more achievements, beating each game on easy and beating each game on hard. At first I was pretty scared we were actually going to have to play Lion King on the hardest difficulty. However, the Sega Genesis cheats from back in the day actually still work. So I'm going to go ahead and leave those in the description below. You can also catch those in my Aladdin and Lion King videos. There is a cheat in Aladdin to automatically beat a level, so you pretty much just keep inputting that cheat until you beat the game. You do that for the easy difficulty and then the hard difficulty. And then for Lion King, The cheat enables invincibility, like a god mode basically, you can't get hurt. And then also it has a level select, so we can pick the last level in Lion King, and all we need to do is beat the last level in Lion King on the easy difficulty and the hardest difficulty. As long as you watch my Aladdin and Lion King achievement guides, you are sure to get your full 1000 gamer score or platinum trophy in just about an hour or an hour and a half. Aside from the achievements, I highly recommend playing these games. These games are absolute classics. Lion King and Aladdin, I think, were the two first games I ever played. The price is a bit steep right now at $30. However, I thought it was worth it. I'm sure most people will wait till it is on sale. As always, guys, I appreciate you tuning in. If this video helped you out, please leave a comment and don't forget to like and subscribe.